Well, at Purdue University, Neil Armstrong's alma mater, our own Aran Hammy dived deeper into Armstrong's life by talking with a friend of his.
Aran joining us in Wapakoneta with what he learned.
I caught up with an author and former journalist who met Neil Armstrong soon after the moon landing. He shared some great stories about who Armstrong was at Purdue and after making history.
John Norberg met Neil Armstrong while he was a journalist for the local paper in West Lafayette. They developed a friendship after several interactions, and Norberg said he learned how modest Armstrong was in life and about the moon landing.
Several of us had a beer and pizza with Neil and Gene at a local place here, Bruno's. Incredible experience to sit there for an evening with the first and last men to walk on the moon. Well, they talked about their friends, they talked about their families and their grandchildren. The one thing they never talked about was walking on the moon.
Even when Armstrong returned to Purdue as a war veteran to complete his degree, Norberg said he never bragged about his accomplishments. Talking about Armstrong's school years, Norberg cited two loves of his love to fly and his love for Wapakoneta.
He flew a plane home from Purdue once there during his college years and did some damage to it, had a little problem. They had to put it on a trailer and haul it back. Of course, he got a lot of kidding for that. Wapakoneta was important to him. It was an important part of his life.
Armstrong must have learned from early mistakes, because when the two first met on the 10-year anniversary of the moon landing, Armstrong said his ability to land safely on the moon should be the most memorable moment, not his famous quote.
He said, "Really, that wasn't the important thing I said that day." I said, "Well, and what was?" He said, "The Eagle has landed." He said it was very difficult to land that lunar module. Very difficult. We'd never done it.
Norberg added that even after all their interactions, there was still much he didn't know about Armstrong until he saw the papers he donated to Purdue. Norberg does know that Armstrong has influenced students to come to Purdue to be the next generation to fly through space.
I think the legacy he leaves us is how to conduct yourself personally, how to be a human being who cares about other human beings and is not self-centered.
Norberg had so many more stories to share, including the time Armstrong forgot a speech and doing something completely unheard of at a press conference. I'll have that full interview up on my Facebook page. Right now, I'll send it back to you, Leslie and Jeff.
All right. Thank you very much, Aran.